Hello guys, this is Sushil again with another upload, and this time I'm going to sculpt and check that model in Maya. This is a sculpture of stylized cartoon model. So I have never done this before, because I usually whenever I started sculpting, I got in my mind that having some kind of creatures, like a human kind of character. But this is the first time I am going to try this, cartoony kind of character, but not exactly the cartoony kind of character. If you can check the final outcome, you will understand. So basically, what I'm doing here is like, whenever somebody starts with, stylized models, they I usually do it in using the zremesher concept, but I am using dynamesh here. So this is basic sculpting method, just giving the shape for the spear which we use. I am using dynavax spear, as you can see, and then dynamesh is enabled already, I'm just going with the sculpting and giving the shape for the model. So basically the test is there is a concept called zremesher in zbrush, but how exactly this zremesher work, like in terms of animation? The thing is like, whenever we start with the planning of animation on some characters, so there is a process. Actually, my last uploads on how exactly to start with the 3D animation, that explains the complete process of animation or animating something, which exactly starts with sculpting the character again, and then because there I just used this creature kind of character. So you can just check those tutorials also if you want to. So the concept which I have used is I have sculpted the character in ZBrush, and then after that I took that thing in Maya, and then I retopolize the character depending on how exactly the animation works, actually to animatic form. So as we know that facial expressions and facial animations, as well as the body animations and all, that needs a well retopolized model. So for that, actually I have followed all the steps, but I was really curious about, because most of the tutorials I usually wanted to watch, like in ZBrush also. So there were some of the tutorials which I have followed, that they are showing that okay, yes, we can do this retopology, the animation formula, forming retopology in ZBrush also, like using this. There is zremesher, the guide brush is there. Okay, zremesher guide brush is there in ZBrush. You can see in this video. So using that, we can use the guides. But the thing is like, yeah, we can achieve the things. Okay, here if you can check the video, you will understand what exactly gone right and gone wrong or something. Because the way if we started sculpting itself in using this zremesher, the spear, then already remeshed spear, if we can use, then the most of the topology will stay even. There will be even cost and all, and then you can use the guides to form that facial that retopology, that topology is there, the facial topology you can form somehow. But most of the time, what I can say is it is lucky if you get exactly what you wanted to, or what you are looking for. but it is not mandatory that you will get the exact, you know, form of that retopology which you are looking for. But yes, the main concern of this video is, like, I just wanted to go with a little bit, you know, fast. So the thing is, like, quickest form of animations. Like, the thing is, as we all know, animations takes a lot of time. Okay, while starting with the characters and then the retopology, then rigging, and after that, so many things, animations, renders, and everything. If you can go on, check, and consider that the process of this animation is really tedious, and it's very lengthy, and definitely somebody who is having another great, you know, what we can say is the patience. That particular person can achieve this, you know, animations easily. But the thing is, like, let's say I want to reduce the steps. Like, say I'm creating a character, and then I just wanted to reduce the step. Like, because the thing is, like, once you create the character, even though you can directly go with the Maya as well, as see, this sculpting is little bit easier for the artist, okay, the one who do artwork using the brush and all. So that the one who is having so much of talent, you know, in the field of art, for those guys the sculpting helps a lot. The one who is technically good and having much patience, those guys can go with the go directly with the Maya, and then they start modeling itself. So, but the one who is not good at, or sometimes, you know, that even modeling looks tedious, then if you want to just move it quickly and, you know, form the faces or whatever the kind of characters which you are planning to, then definitely sculpting is better option. I think for, at least for me, it is better option. So I usually do, whenever I just wanted to try to give a shape or something, or, you know, start with some animation, I'll directly go with the sculpting and then start. But I can say that the models which we do in Maya is really great, because there what exactly the process of this retopology will definitely be reduced, because the thing is, like, at the time of modeling itself, if you can go with the principles of this topology formations, then definitely you no need to worry about retopology step. Directly you can go just model the character and directly go with the UV and texturing, and then the rigging, and then the animation part. And the type of object which you get, the type of the thing, once you model directly in Maya, that will be thing is, like, only smoother, and definitely it is having a good topology also, because everything you did in Maya itself, so there is no issue of the animation, okay. So, and perfect and smooth you can get. But the thing is, like, when you are going in the art formation, okay, some sort of VFX things, movies, or, you know, some kind of horrific characters, or the things which is having details on the on the faces or body, then I think this ZBrush kind of ZBrush or blender also is having this sculpting powers, and sculptries is there, then Horuni is also there. There are so many softwares where you can go and start with the sculpting. So there the details and some kind of the things which you want to create, the detailings and, you know, some kind of extra what we can see, the features on the body that can be done, or that can be draw, or that can be achieving, you know, the softwares like ZBrush and Blender and something. So, but yeah, achieving in that way or getting that kind of things will be easy here. And that doesn't mean that you can you cannot create, you know, the stylized model here. That too you can create. So the thing is like time consume for that creation of that model in Maya and ZBrush, if you can differentiate or consider, then here the sculpting process will take a lesser time than the modeling. But the thing is like there will be another step added, the retopology. Okay, that is what I'm as I see actually. I even have worked in Maya while, you know, modeling the character. And I did sculpting more. Okay, I did sculpting more, and then retopology, because I love to do that that retopology also. So and the thing is like the time of retopolization, there is no need to work on every part of the body most of the time. You can just take care of the things which are like the features, like a face and all that are the main animatic faces, the like features of the body. So that you can just take care and then retopolize those parts only, and then that is the process that's done. And if there is some kind of creature and something, if you are working on, then definitely the whole body must be retopolized. You know, that the process should be like you must have to work on whole body. So basically the thing is like the results are definitely good in both the way, but ZBrush used and more, you know, kind of achieving some kind of artistic form and form of, you know, models, the VFX, then creatures, monsters or something, and forming of some environmental assets and all that can be done, and same in Maya too. So Maya is completely for, you know, the best is for the animation and all, and ZBrush you can create so many things at the same time. So here I am, I'm just going with this character. So I just wanted to give a little bit of shape. I didn't bother about having the eyebrows here in the process. I just because this is the first actually kind of model which I am doing here, sculpting, which is in the form of or this kind of, you know, stylized model which I can say. But I don't know the when you see the result, you might say it is a stylized or you might not say, because the process of working is little bit different compared to others, because I just worked on, you know, these dynamic things, and just I keep on this sculpting to give the shape. That's it. I'm just working on eyelids, and then the eyes. See, the thing is like when you work in Maya, so that this UV creation of UV as well as and creation of the texture is there. Now that is some again that kind of work is, you can say, this extra adding, you know, extra added work. But when I started, I really loved to because I usually do some arts, sketching, portraits and all. So I love to work with the this pen tool. So it feels me like okay, just like I'm using a brush or something, and I'm doing some art, a paint or something. So that is like kind of very interesting part. I don't know why, but every time whenever I wanted to start with some animation concepts and then want to do some animations or creating models or something, then I just get in touch with this ZBrush first. I don't think about this Maya or some other softwares, rather to come and start with ZBrush only, because the feel of doing art here like with a pen, so that is very different for me. I love drawing the things, so here whenever I come in ZBrush, I start working in my way. See, even though for this model also I haven't planned anything, so I just planned like okay, this will be some kind of a cartoony model, that's it. So that is the only plan I had, but I didn't have any kind of a shape or kind of face in my mind. I just went on working, so somehow I got the shape like this. So basically what I meant is like it depends on your interest. So you can, if you are good with the Maya, you can directly start working in Maya or Blender or any other softwares. It depends, but I really like to work with ZBrush. So the reason is definitely because of this artistic form of doing this, sculpting and everything. Because I usually do sculpt this so many models by the using mud, I think. Yeah, that real sculpting also I did. So I don't know why, but there is attachment with this ZBrush. Like, I feel like okay, real sculpting here. And whenever I use this software, I feel like okay, just like oh yeah, this kind of art I can. That means like whatever the imaginations I get, even though in between. If I get some imaginations like working on some kind of like some kind of different shapes or some kind of some creature or something, like so whatever the imagination, what I think is like the ZBrush is kind of a software where you can explore your imaginations. You can do whatever you want. You can thing is like you can go and sculpt anything you want, I think. So any shape you wanted to, there is no kind restriction kind of thing. But if you use this standard softwares like Maya, like modeling softwares, I don't know, maybe the professionals can do easily, but starters like us, I don't think like we will go, because if your mind is very very artistic, if your mind is completely depends, and the kind of work you did is like art thing, and then this is the the piece of software, definitely it will be helpful for you guys. So now I am just going with this, giving the colors, these textures, we can say. So this is the form of poly painting. As this is, you know, stylized model, and I think we don't exactly require the skin coloring kind of thing, because I'm not going into that much detail. I just wanted to try whether if I go with ZBrush completely from A to Z, so from modeling and then retopology, so will that work in Maya? That is what my concern. So that is what my concern, and on that I was like just working on that. So here you can see the position of one eye is little bit mismatched. I can see here that we can fix in Maya anyhow. At the time of animation also we can fix those things. But try to have everything in symmetry. So symmetry, that helps actually. That helps at the time of animations also. Now usually the thing is like we don't require what we can see. Because whatever we added here is like all acts as a materials. We don't even require the things of creating the textures here, but that is my style of working actually. I really work on textures. Every time it automatically force me to once you complete with the poly painting or something, then just go with the unwrapping and then texture formation in this. And I don't bother exactly how exactly this UVs are formed in this and all. Now see, I'm using the guides here, and then I'm just zremeshing this. So when I see after zremeshing that face, the area of face is exactly what I'm looking for, but eyes didn't form exact, what we can see, the topology there. So there it failed actually, but I wanted to check it anyhow. I wanted to check it in Maya, but face, that mouth shape is on that, at that particular place it got exact topology. Yes, I'm just as I said, this exactly we don't require projecting everything, we don't exactly require, but anyhow this is the E1 color, and even though without having any colors also directly we just remesh everything, you just remesh everything and then just send everything to the, just create export as a OBJ, and there in Maya you can directly give the colors because you know the colors, a kind of colors you have given. But as I said, this is my hobby, like even though I might think or not, it forced me to okay this is the process of, like every time I used to work like this, so this is the process I used to follow, like kind of that I just used and I just created these textures here for everything. Yes, but we definitely don't need, because even though in poly painting also I'm not painting particularly, I'm not using brushes there and to form something. Some different colors, because if it is even color, then just applying some materials colors is pretty enough exactly for everything. So I'm just working on this UV creation and as well as applying the poly paints as the textures.
Basically, it's a form of like creation of textures, okay, kind of thing. So then afterwards, like for teeth and then the torso, I didn't feel that, okay, we require, because then I got like, okay, yes, we can use materials itself. So now exporting everything, so whatever the work we have done, just exporting everything. I'm just using a new folder to place every content from the ZBrush now. So then starting with the Maya, and just wanted to check how exactly it looks. But here I just accidentally again opened the ZBrush, then I needed to close it again. Basically, like working on some kind of different artistic format, and then as I said, like ZBrush is very already it is very popular software. So as you can see here, we got our model here. So as we didn't apply anything, I didn't work on any textures on this teeth, so as I said, we can directly apply any new material on that we can do. So I was just preparing for this face rigging. So I just tried to, okay, let's sum up and then try to rig and check whether it works. And believe me, this somehow it was like very near to like okay. And then when I tried, I usually do advanced skeleton 5 for this rigging process, face rigging process. The whole, like the complete body rigging as well as the face rigging, I usually do in advanced skeleton 5. Again, that plugin is really great. I tried it, but definitely it failed. I just so there itself you can see this eye is like, the eyeball is like having below, like okay, that is the thing is like, yes, the first thing what we do did here is like yeah, but maybe it's my mistake that I just moved the model a little bit above the surface, the ground surface, so this eyeball like directly when we started, when I see this, definitely I was just trying to select something and I didn't get, then I just went on like checking, but inside from this ring I got the exact lines. So that means like the thing is accuracy is not there, but when we see this at the part of a mouth, there that accuracy is like totally fine. We got the complete accurate things, but if you can see down, see the face, everything we just got messed up. So this is it guys, like as I said, zremesher definitely works, but the thing is like the kind of model you have created and sculpting, okay, if the area of the sculpting is
great, then definitely it will work. So see you later.